Hey guys, it's Jenny. Welcome back to my channel. I'm actually currently on my PS3. I haven't really used it in a while. I want to say it's been some years. But I'm trying to get it set up so that my son can play with it. And I've been trying to get GTA 5 to play. And I don't know if everybody's having this issue, but I know a lot of people are. When you try to turn the game on, it goes to black screen. So I'm sure you know what I'm talking about here. So I'm trying to load it now. And this is pretty much what happens. It goes to the back screen, nothing's working. I've already got my PlayStation updated, all the latest updates from the system, so I know it's nothing to do with that. So I've done some research, people are saying to wait till the music turns off and try to update the game and L1, R1, stuff like that. So I'm gonna try some of these solutions with you guys and see if any of them work, and that way we can possibly hopefully eliminate some of these solutions together. So let me go ahead and restart my system and I'll be right back. Alright, so first thing I'm gonna try to do is see if there's an update that we could access from here. Okay, so latest version's installed. That's not gonna fix this issue. So let me research the next solution and see if it works. So the next solution I saw was to hold L1 and R1 as soon as you start the game. And if it works, then you're supposed to see the lightness adjustment bar. So we're gonna try that one next. It's gonna be kind of difficult because I'm doing this with one hand. I'm gonna hit X really fast and then I'm gonna hold L1 and R1. Okay. This doesn't. Seem to be doing anything either. If this doesn't do anything, then I'm going to try the safe mode option, and as a last resort, we'll delete all of our save data and reinstall the game and see if that helps. Alright, so this one's not working. I'm going to go ahead and restart my PlayStation 3 again, and we'll try the next solution. Alright, so the next option is to go into save mode, which I'm in save mode here. If you need to know how to get into save mode and how to access that, I'll do a separate video showing how to do that. So, it says we need to do the restore file system and the rebuild database. So we're going to go ahead and do this one first. Yes. And do this one. And then I'll be right back and we'll go ahead and do the next one. All right, so we've done the restore file system and we'll see if that fixes the issue. And if it doesn't, we'll do the second option and see if it can. All right, it doesn't look like this one's worked. Nope. Alright, so we're gonna go back to safe mode and do option 4. Okay, so we're back in safe mode and we're gonna do the rebuild database, option 4. Yes. And we'll see if this one helps. When I did option 3, I got a message that said something was corrupted and it reset my PlayStation 3 again. I'm not sure if it's gonna happen this time, so I'll just keep the camera on and see if that happens this time. Okay, so it's been rebuilt and we'll see. Oh, so I guess it's like a little process here. Alright, so it's going really quickly, which is great. this doesn't work, the only other option I know of is to delete all of the data, reinstall the game, which sucks because this game's already been beat on my PS3, so it's gonna suck. So it doesn't look like that fixed the issue. Alright, well, I'm gonna restart my PlayStation 3 again. I'm gonna delete all the data and reinstall the game. So just give me 1 second. Alright, so I'm just in here deleting a GTA 5 data that I'm seeing. I don't know how long this is going to take. I'm going to go ahead and delete all the data and I'll be right back. Alright, so as you can see, I've deleted all GTA 5 files that I saw in here. Yeah, so that's been done. I'm going to try to click on it one more time and if it doesn't work, I'm not really sure. It's not saying that it needs to install, which makes me think that I've missed something, so I'm going to try this one more time and just do a little bit more research if it doesn't work and see how I can reinstall the game completely. If that doesn't work, then I don't really know what else to do to fix. It looks like it's not working. I'm gonna research one more thing and we'll be right back. Alright, so this is the last thing I saw online, was just to take the disk out, put it back in, and see if it will automatically start installing. And if this doesn't work, I literally don't know how to fix this problem. So maybe somebody can let me know. Oh my god. That's crazy. So, alright, so before I even click OK, someone said wait till the music or whatever goes away. So I'm gonna wait. Just be safe. Let's see if that works. And I don't hear it. So we're gonna go ahead and click it. So now it's like frozen. Okay, so I want to say that like I'm really impressed that it's actually showing me something because everything else was a box screen. Like it's giving me the option to update, but I'm literally clicking X and it's doing nothing. So what I think I'm gonna do is like a little bit more research and see what I can do from here. So give me 1 second. Alright, so this time I restarted PlayStation because it froze. And instead of putting the disc in, I left the disc in and I just clicked triangle for options and went for the latest update. And it seems to be updating, so we'll see what happens. Well, as you can see, I reinstalled the game and that did not fix the problem. And it literally took like 3 to 4 hours to reinstall again because it kept crashing. So I literally don't know how to fix this issue. If anyone knows, please let me know so we can all help each other out. Alright, thanks for watching.